and welcome back to Vlogmas. Maybe I should call it Vlogmas with the amount of mask stuff that I have to talk about. I've received a few comments in the past, good ones, about, wow, I love your mask collection, and there was one on a different video, I can't remember which one it was, and it was, hello, I like how you store your masks, so I thought maybe you'd like to see how I store my masks. It's not really that interesting, but you might like to see it anyway, and I will just show you all of the masks that I have. This is my box of masks. It lives in my wardrobe over there on one of the shelves. Doesn't really matter which one, but it just sits, like, well, I think for you guys it sits like this, so I can just reach in and touch the masks. What I have going on here is obviously masks and filters. I don't use the filters, so to be honest, don't really know why I'm keeping them. But here we are. Maybe I'll just get rid of them after this because this is getting quite tight. Like, it's hard to just pull one out because that happens. And you get like three. I mean, options, but not ideal. That's kind of it, really. It's just masks in a box, currently stacked up for no real reason other than I guess I can see it all. Let's look at the masks themselves. That's more fun. I ordered some really nice patterned masks from my usual online wish shop. And when they turned up, they were plain and in colours that I already had. It's like definitely a first world problem, not the end of the world, but kind of annoying when I get really excited about patterns because I have to wear it on my face. And usually if you order something, you want to get the thing that you ordered. But I did get a refund for them, and they said I could keep the masks, which is good. It was white and fish, black and grey, black and red. So I got black, grey, and white. I can see what happened there. I'm going to leave them unopened because in my local community, I've had some people asking about masks and whether it might help them. So I have been offering them around to anybody that might need them. Because I don't need as many masks as I have. I don't use the filters. I'm not filtering anything out. So, what? They come with the masks. It's not like I'm buying the filters with each mask. That's just how they come. So I have lots of extra filters that I don't really need. If anybody wants them, reach out to me. Probably best to do it on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram. All the links for that are down below in the description. As always, let me know if you want them or you want to know more about them. A gift to my ice mice. This one, you might remember this one from my which mask type is best for cold urticaria. I'll put a link in the card above up there. That was a really fun video to shoot and kind of helpful, kind of not helpful. Didn't tell me anything I didn't already know. But I kept this one because it has snowflakes on it. I have not used it since, but I like snowflakes, so maybe I should try it. I have these two. This one has a cat. I think it's a cat. It's supposed to be a cat and it says meow. This one has a bunny on it and it says perfect day. I got it because it was green. It doesn't have like a tight seal on it. I use these two particular masks for when I'm out cycling because you don't want to have such a tight seal when you are doing physical activity. So when I'm out on my bike, need to breathe. Another type of mask. I found a new shop that has lots and lots of really pretty patterns. And also because of the new medication, I can now get this different style and still be okay. It is a little bit more of a risk and I can't say that every single time I've done it, I haven't had a reaction. But it has been better. These are slightly looser masks. They also don't have the rigid nose bit and it doesn't form as tight a seal, but it still forms a pretty good seal around my cheeks. And they are so pretty. Like, look at this one. You might have seen this one before. on my Instagram. If you're not already following me on Instagram, you definitely should, because I post a lot of my mask based outfits on there, and you can see little cold out carrier tips and tricks. I've got this one and sort of these two. I'm going to talk about these specific patterns more in another video that I have planned. I have some of it filmed, some of it not, so if you could just hold on till then, that would be great. But this one I got because it's very pharmacology based, kind of. I mean, it's drug based, but also it's sort of it looks more sciencey based than maybe this one. Again, we'll talk about it in the other video. Also, who doesn't love melted chocolate? This one actually does have a bit for a filter in it, but these three don't, and they're all from the same shop. So that was a surprise, so this one's a little thicker. And then the rest of my masks. And by the rest of my masks, I mean the ones that are clean. Look at all this dust. Good job I'm not allergic to dust, isn't it? Got black. More black. More black. Navy blue. The pink one that I talked about in the video that I'm going to link up here. Pink one, don't really wear it. This one I haven't really worn since it did the rounds in all of the newspapers, because it doesn't really fit the way I like it. It's quite big. The difference is around the chin area, kind of. I have kind of a small face, so it matters. Another grey one. A blue one. And those are all my block colours, I think. I think I have another grey one at my partner's house. And a pink one. So these ones, I have more than this. There are definitely two in the wash. One's there, drying. It's the gingham one, again, on my Instagram, down there. There's one in my friend's car. Losing masks is a thing. So we have this one, which is like a tealy floral print thing. This one, which is like blue with tiny, tiny amounts of pink on it. It's really cute. I think I wore this on my first date with my partner. I definitely wore it on a fancy date. This one, which I fitted in How to Fit a Vlog Mask, which I will also put up there if I haven't run out of cards. This one's an interesting one. It's quite pink and quite, I don't know, cream. It's not really my colour, but it is cute. And I do wear it sometimes. It's just not, I don't think it's ever been my first pick. And then the wedding mask, which is what I'm gonna call it. Every time I wear yellow, I wear this. Whenever I wear orange, I wear this, unless I have a different accent colour going with it. And if I ever wear this shade of green, I wear this. And sometimes I just wear it no matter what I'm wearing, because it's pretty. Finally, in the box, we have a box in a box, and it's just all of the spare O-rings and end pieces that come with all of the masks. I have collected quite a few. That's my mask tour, I suppose. I don't know if that's been interesting at all, but it is a fun Vlogmas video. Don't forget to like this video if you have enjoyed my mask tour. Drop a comment with what mask is your favourite. Do you have a similar storage situation? I would like to hear about it. And subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and ring that notification bell so you get notified every single time I post a new video. Videos go up every Saturday at 6 PM UK time, with at least one bonus video every single month, apart from this month, where it's Vlogmas and it's 25 videos in 25 days. See ya!